In this example, we're required to find the acceleration of blocks A and B. It is given that block A is of mass 10 kg and B is of 20 kg. We're required to find acceleration when they're released from rest. In this situation, the first thing we analyze is all the forces acting on the block. We can see this block B will experience its weight 20 g in downwards direction. It'll experience a tension in the string in upward direction. In this whole string, the tension will remain same. And in this string, we can say tension will be 2t. As we can consider this pulley to be ideal. So net downward force acting on pulley has to be balanced by the net upward force acting on it. So this block A will be pulled in upward direction with the force 2t. And in downward direction, it'll experience the parallel component of force along the inclined plane. That is, 10g sine theta. That is 10g sine 30 degrees. Now in this situation, if we draw the free body diagrams of 10 kg and 20 kg blocks, we can see free body diagrams of A. Here it can be written that it'll be experiencing downward 10g. In this direction, it'll be experiencing 2t tension along the inclined. And perpendicular to the inclined, it'll be experiencing a normal reaction which is applied by the inclined plane onto it. It'll also exert the same normal force on the plane in downward direction. In this situation, this angle would be 30 degrees. So we can see along the direction of motion, the component of its weight will be 10g sine 30 degrees, which we've drawn. And it can be considered that this block A is going up with acceleration A1. If we talk about block B, say it is coming down with an acceleration A2. Here we again draw A is moving with acceleration A1. For block B, we can draw the free body diagram as it is experiencing its weight 20g in downward direction and tension T in upward direction. It is coming down with an acceleration A2. Now we can easily write down the equation of motion of both the blocks, but before that we can see they're connected by a string pulley system, so we can develop a constrained relation between the accelerations A1 and A2. Here you can see if this block A will slide up by a distance x. This string is connected to this pulley, so we can say this pulley will come down by a distance x, and it'll loosen this string on both sides by x, so this B will fall down by a distance 2x. So we can say as B is sliding down by twice the distance A is going up. So the similar relation with exists between their acceleration. So we can write A2 is equal to A1. If we write down the equation of motion of these blocks, for this block A, we can directly write, it is having an external force 2t on the block, in upward direction, and in downward direction it is 10g sine 30 degrees, which can be written as 5g. So its equation of motion can be written as 2t minus 5g is equal to 10a1. Similarly for block B, if we write the equation of motion in downward direction, we can write 20g minus t is equal to 20 into acceleration A2, which is 2a1. This is equation 1 and this is our equation 2. We're required to find the acceleration. We can multiply equation 2 by 2, and then we add it. Due to multiplying the equation by 2, we can see this tension factor gets cancelled out. On adding the two equations, this'll give us 40g minus 5g. That is, 35g is equal to. This'll be 40 into 2, 80 plus 10, 90 A1. So we can see the value of acceleration A1 is equal to 35g by 90. That is, 35 by 9 meters per second square. As the value of A1 is 35 by 9 meter per second square, here we can write acceleration of block A is equal to A1. It is 35 by 9 meters per second square. and acceleration of block B, which is twice A1, can be written as 70 by 9 meters per second square. So these are the answers to this problem.